Some people are probably thinking this is the end of the world.
That's true.
Do you think it could be?
Yes.
How can you say that?
That wasn't the answer you wanted.
Couldn't you pretend to be like you used to be? Give me some comfort.
People break down into two groups. When they experience something lucky, group number one sees it as more than luck, more than coincidence. They see it as a sign, evidence that there is someone up there watching out for them. Group number two sees it as just pure luck, a happy turn of chance. I'm sure the people in group number two are looking at those 14 lights in a very suspicious way. For them, this situation is a 50-50. Could be bad. Could be good. But deep down, they feel that whatever happens, they're on their own. And that fills them with fear. Yeah, there are those people. But there's a whole lot of people in the group number one. And they see those 14 lights. They're looking at a miracle. And deep down, they feel that whatever's going to happen, there'll be someone there to help them. And that fills them with hope. See, what you have to ask yourself is, what kind of person are you? Are you the kind that sees signs, sees miracles? Or do you believe that people just get lucky? Or look at the question this way. Is it possible that there are no coincidences?
I was at this party once. I'm on the couch with Random McKinney. She was just sitting there, looking beautiful, staring at me. I go to lean in and kiss her, and I realize I have gum in my mouth. So I turn, take out the gum, stuff it in a paper cup next to the sofa, and turn around. Random McKinney throws up all over herself. I knew the second it happened, it was a miracle. I could have been kissing her when she threw up. That would have scarred me for life. I may never have recovered. I'm a miracle man. Those lights are a miracle.
There you go.
So which type are you?
Do you feel comforted?
Yeah, I do.
Then what does it matter? I never told you the last words that Colleen said before they let her die. She said, "See." And her eyes glazed a bit. And then she said, "Swing away." You know why she said that? Because the nerve endings in her brain were firing as she died. And some random memory of us at one of your baseball games just popped into her head. There is no one watching out for us, Merrill.